I was thanking you for the opportunity to make those brief remarks here. And that is because today is indeed a glorious moment in the life of APGA administration in Anambra State. Chief Chukwuma Soludo captured it in his speech, but I felt I should come to reinforce what APGA has done in Anambra State. Of course, I was part of the journey from 2006, and I can tell you very proudly, ladies and gentlemen, that the uncommon transformation Anambra State has witnessed since 2006 is because APGA is in charge of the government. His Excellency Chiwule Obiano has kept very faithfully with the APGA programs here. He brought his own touch to delivering quality governance that is very, very comprehensive. We've just come out of the Christmas season. It has been very peaceful. And this is the fifth Christmas Anambra State has celebrated without any security breach. We can go on and on to tell you, because I'm happy the traditional leaders are here in great number. Oftentimes, when we celebrate some milestones, we forget the enabling environment that made it possible. APGA has called so many good marks here, and sometimes you take some of them for granted. Because when you start getting things that are good, you take good things for granted until bad people take over. When they take over, you regret. This hotel, which is the latest addition to the legacy of APGA and Anambra State, the project was inherited by His Excellency in 2014. I was here at that time. And I can tell you that what we met here was the carcass, not the columns. You could see through. I was just columns standing. And there was palpable anxiety whether this hotel will be completed, particularly from the host community. But Dr. Wule Obiano, in keeping with his attitude to work, there was no external works. No external works here. These things you are seeing, paved stones and the surroundings, including the swimming pool when we take the tour. Nothing was here. And Your Excellency, within 4 years, you delivered a 5-star hotel. It's completed and furnished, ready for use. It's only possible with a government that's committed to the welfare of the people. When you said 3 C's, I told you, Governor Obiano promised 4 C's. When we were campaigning in 2013, he said 4 C's. He will complete, he will commission, he will continue and commence new projects. Within 5 years, Governor Obiano has commenced many new projects and completed them. Apart from continuing and completing the things he inherited, commissioning them, he commenced so many new projects and completed them within 5 years. So, Excellency, with emotion, I stand before you as an indigenous of this local government and a great player in APGA. I know the journey. Let me recognize the council chairman of Anocha, Ndreku Obejofor. And then let me recognize Igwe Abga, Pope Abga, Chief Benjiobi. I'm recognizing him because if you're coming into this hotel, you see a billboard there. Well, this is Abga Pope's cap. His Excellency's picture is there. You see my red cap there, and you see him. When people were making noise about this project, he erected that billboard. Well, he had faith that he would do it. And people coming in here today, you see that billboard before coming in here. This is the Abga spirit and the Abga family. I will not take so much of your time because we have some items to cover and to let you go. But let me tell our people sincerely from my heart, any good work deserves commendation and further support. I stand here to speak because Abga family, seeing what has happened here, I would have said, I've seen it all, let me go. But there is still so much to be done by Abga, not only for Anambra State, but for Ndibo as a people. I tell you this, so we'll continue. This Abga family is there. I've been here for 3 weeks, going around seeing people. And I want to tell our people, do not make any mistake. This party is still the way for our people. It's still the way. The governor needs the Abga family to work with him. I've just been in the Senate for 10 months. I know how I have collaborated with him. You can attest to that. So do not forget, when you are enjoying good governance and you begin to talk about one or two things and you lose sight of the ball. Don't lose sight of the ball. That's what I'm telling my people, all of you, with every amount of passion and respect. So that what the governor is doing, he's still here for 3 years and Excellency, 3 years and 4 months for you as governor. You've not even started to end. You have 3 years and 4 months to hand over to another Abga governor here. That's what's going to happen here. We are ready to do it with you. You hand over to an Abga governor. Abga will take this state to that enviable height of our dream. Nobody can stop it because we'll be alive to achieve it. Yes, sir, so on behalf of the people of Anocha local government, let me tell you about 5 roads that we need you to complete. You've awarded them. The roads are under construction, but I can tell you our people want you. If you deliver these 5 roads, they are not big roads. They are short roads. We will never forget you. Even now, we will never forget you. We will never forget you even now. There's a road from St. Matthias Catholic Church here, crossing through Mwole here, to the old road from Wagon. That job road has been awarded. You need little money to complete it. There are 2 roads you have awarded in Nri. Nri here. One goes to Nimo. The other one goes to Yetoro. Little money, Excellency, you will finish those roads. And they will open up that place to Nimo and solve a lot of traffic jam at Wagu here during festive periods. Excellency, there's another road you've awarded. It is at Adazienu. It's about 3 kilometers or so, linking Nopa. Job is ongoing there. May the people of that community want that road completed. It's part of the prayers we're adding to you. We're not only a twist, but we felt we should tell you because in the spirit of happiness with what you have done, you can push it a little more. Finally, Your Excellency. Finally, Your Excellency. The other road is also a small road. You awarded it to Sages. That road links Munowagro to Amezike. It comes through this major highway again. You've awarded it. But the contractor, I'm sorry, needs to be removed from that site. I don't know who it is. It's a short road. A lot has been done. If you just put little effort there, that road will be done. And other people will not be talking to you about roads again because you've done so much. You've completed Agusibo roads. The Agusibo roads have been completed. Adasimu roads awarded by you, almost all completed. So we are not saying that our brother who started this hotel and handed over to you, we have no regrets. You've delivered the hotel again. All these things you've done for us, we'll never forget. So on behalf of our people here, we assure you of our continued support. Anytime you need anything from us, consider it done. Finally, because this is election time, the governor may not say that, but I am the beginning of Abia here. Yes, I'll tell you without missing words, I beg all of you to vote for all Abia candidates in this election. All of them. When you finish, because I like going to debates. If anybody says that what I'm saying here can be controverted, I will ask the person to come to a television debate. I tell you why Abia should be supported. All our candidates, National Assembly, State Assembly, Abia should be voted for so that the benefits this party has offered the people of Anambra State will be sustained. Thank you and God bless you.
Thank you. Yes, so the hour is here. The die is cast.